Hello students, welcome to our channel Learning Notebook. In today's video, we are going to do complete chapter of division for class 4. But before starting with this video, let me tell you that we have made videos on every chapter of class 4 mathematics. We also have interesting worksheets and quizzes on each chapter. You can find all of them on our channel Learning Notebook. Also, you can see a list of all such videos on our website. The link to our website is below in the description box. So let's see what all topics we are going to cover today in this video. First, we will understand division fact. Then we will learn division of 3-digit by 1-digit number, division of 4-digit by 1-digit number. After that, we will understand division by 10, 100 and 1000 with and without long division method. Then we will learn division of 3-digit number by 2-digit number, division of 4-digit number by 2-digit number. And then we will also learn how to solve word problems related to division. In the end, I will give you a practice worksheet. So stay tuned and watch the entire video. Let's start and first understand division facts. First division fact is, when a number is divided by itself, the quotient is 1. Let's take an example. If we divide number 18 by itself, we will get the quotient as 1. Second division fact is, when a number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. Let's take an example. If we divide number 56 by 1, we get the quotient as 56, which is the number itself. Third division fact is, when 0 is divided by any number, the quotient is always 0. For example, if we divide 0 by any number, let's say 76, we will get the quotient as 0. Next division fact is, division by 0 is meaningless. For example, if we divide number 7 by 0, it will be meaningless. And the last division fact is, division and multiplication are related. Every multiplication fact has two division facts. To understand this, let's consider a multiplication fact. 5 into 8 equals to 40. So it has two division facts. One is, 40 divided by 8 equals to 5. And second division fact is, 40 divided by 5 equals to 8. Similarly, consider the multiplication fact, 9 into 4 equals to 36. It also has two division facts. 36 divided by 4 equals to 9. And 36 divided by 9 equals to 4. So students, these are the 5 division facts. So now students, can you tell me the multiplication fact for 30 divided by 2 equals to 15 from the given options? Is it A, B or C? Yes, it is A. 2 multiplied by 15 equals to 30. Now let's do some questions based on these division facts. First is, 45 divided by 1 equals to dash. So here answer is 45, because we learned when a number is divided by 1, the quotient is the number itself. Next question is 14 divided by 14 equals to dash. Here the answer is 1, because we know when a number is divided by itself, the quotient is 1. Third question is 0 divided by 19 equals to dash. Here the answer is 0, because we learned when 0 is divided by any number, the quotient is always 0. Let's see the next question. Dash divided by 1 equals to 99. So what would be the answer here? Yes, it will be 99, because when a number is divided by 1, then only the quotient can be number itself. Next question is 45 divided by 0 equals to dash. Answer is meaningless, because division by 0 is meaningless. Students, we also have a video on complete chapter of money for class 4. I'm sure all your doubts related to this chapter money would be resolved after watching this comprehensive video. Now let's start with the division by one digit number. Let's do a question to understand division by one digit number and also how to check the division. Question is, divide 20 by 6 and then check your answer. To divide these two numbers, we will form a 10 and we will put dividend 20 inside the 10 and divisor 6 outside the 10. Now let's divide 20 by 6. We know 6 into 3 equals to 18, and 20 minus 18 equals to 2. So quotient equals to 3 and remainder equals to 2. To check our answer, we will check if dividend equals to quotient into divisor plus remainder. Then only our division is correct. We can also write it as div equals to q into d plus r. So let's put the values here. Q into d is 3 into 6 plus r is plus 2. 3 into 6 is 18. And plus 2 equals to 20. So we have got the dividend, which is equal to the given dividend 20. Therefore, the quotient and remainder are correct. Now we will learn division of 3-digit number by a 1-digit number. Question is, divide 783 by 3. So let's form a 10 and put dividend 783 inside the 10 and divisor 3 outside the 10. Now first we have to divide 7 by 3. 3 into 2 equals to 6, and 7 minus 6 equals to 1. Now we will copy the next digit, 8. So we now have to divide 18 by 3. We know 3 into 6 equals to 18, and 18 minus 18 equals to 0. Let's copy the last digit 3. Now we will divide 3 by 3. We know 3 into 1 equals to 3. And 3 minus 3 equals to 0. So students, we have got the quotient as 261 and remainder as 0. Now let's check our answer by using the same formula which we used in the last question. Dividend equals to Q into D plus R. So let's put the values here. Q is 261, divisor is 3 and remainder is 0. So 261 multiplied by 3 equals to 783 plus 0 equals to 783, which is same as the given dividend. So it means our quotient and remainder are correct. Now let's do division of 4-digit number by a 1-digit number. Question is, divide 5120 by 7. So let's form a tent and put 5120 inside the tent and 7 outside the tent. Now students, we have to divide 5 by 7. But 5 is smaller than 7. So it means we cannot start with the division. So we will take 2 digits here, that is 51. We have to divide 51 by 7. And we know 7 into 7 equals to 49. 51 minus 49 equals to 2. Copy the next digit 2. So we have to divide 22 by 7. 7 into 3 equals to 21 and 22 minus 21 equals to 1. Let's copy the last digit 0. So divide 10 by 7. 7 into 1 equals to 7 and 10 minus 7 equals to 3. So our quotient equals to 731 and remainder equals to 3. Now let's check our division by using the same formula. Dividend equals to Q into D plus R. Put the values here. Q is 731 and D is 7 and remainder is 3. 731 multiplied by 7 equals to 5117 plus 3 equals to 5120, which is same as the given dividend. So it means our answer is correct. Students, for more examples on division of 3-digit and 4-digit by a 1-digit number, you can refer to our separate videos. In these videos, you will find many questions for your practice. The link to these videos are below in the description box. Now we will do division by 10, 100 and 1000. First we will do division by 10. Question is, divide 64 by 10. Let's first divide using long division method. We know 10 into 6 equals to 60. And 64 minus 60 equals to 4. So quotient equals to 6 and remainder equals to 4. Now students, here we observe when a number is divided by 10, then digit at one's place, that is 4, makes up the remainder, and rest of the digits, that is 6, make up the quotient. Now let's do one more question. Divide 243 by 10. Again, we will divide using long division method. We know 10 into 2 equals to 20, and 24 minus 20 equals to 4. Copy the next digit, 3. Now 10 into 4 equals to 40, and 43 minus 40 equals to 3. So quotient equals to 24 and remainder equals to 3. So here also we observe that when a number is divided by 10, digit at one's place, that is 3, makes up the remainder, and rest of the digits, that is 24, make up the quotient. Now let's do division by 10 without using long division method. Question is, divide 6781 by 10 without long division. Students, as we observed in previous questions, digit at one's place makes up the remainder. So here, digit at one's place is 1. So remainder equals to 1. And then we observe rest of the digits make up the quotient. So here, rest of the digits, that is 678, will be the quotient. So students, we have divided number 6781 by 10 without long division. In the same way, let's solve one more question. We have to divide number 9098 by 10. Again, without long division. As we know, digit at one's place will be the remainder. So here, digit at one's place is 8. So 8 is the remainder. And rest of the digits, they will make the quotient. So 909 is the quotient here. Students, we also have a video on complete chapter of multiples and factors for class 4. We also have interesting activities related to multiples of number and finding factors of a number. So I would recommend you to watch these videos. Now we will do division by 100. Students, we have learned division by 10 without long division. Now let's learn division by 100 without long division. Let's divide 238 by 100. Now 100 has two zeros. So we will take two digits, that is digits at ones and tens place. They will make up the remainder now. So here, digits at ones and tens place is 38. So 38 is the remainder here. And rest of the digits make up the quotient. So 2 is the quotient here. Now let's do one more question. This time we have to divide 7352 by 100 without long division. So students, again, digits at ones and tens place make up the remainder. So here 52 is the remainder, and rest of the digits, that is 73, it is the quotient. So we have got the answer as quotient equals to 73 and remainder equals to 52. Students, we would like to tell you that we have made videos on every chapter of class 3, class 4 and class 5 mathematics. We also have related worksheets, quizzes, working models, activities and projects on each chapter. So I would request you to check out our channel Learning Notebook. Now we will do division by 1000. Question is, divide 3451 by 1000 without long division. Now here 1000 has 3 zeros. So 3 digits, that is digits at ones, tens and hundreds place, will make up the remainder. So here remainder is 451. And rest of the digits will make up the quotient. So 3 is the quotient here. Next question is, divide 65397 by 1000 without long division. So again students, digits at ones, tens and hundreds place make up the remainder. So here remainder equals to 397 and rest of the digits make up the quotient. So 65 is the quotient here. So students, till now we have learned division by one digit number, division by 10, 100 and 1000 without long division. Now we will understand division by two digit number. Question is, divide 94 by 13. Students, in this question we will learn how to estimate the quotient. It is very important to understand this method, as we will be using the same method to divide 3 and 4 digit numbers by 2 digit number. So please pay attention here. So let's start the division by forming a tent. Put dividend, that is 94, inside the tent and divisor 13 outside the tent. Now, since the divisor, that is 13, is of 2 digit number, so let's consider 2 digits of dividend, that is 94. And since 94 is greater than 13, we can start with the division. Now students, if you remember the table of 13, then you can do the division directly. But if you do not remember the table of 13, then you have to estimate the quotient. Estimating the quotient is very simple. You just round off both the numbers to nearest 10. It means 94 rounds off to 90 and 13 rounds off to 10. So now we have to divide 90 by 10. Cancel 0 by 0 and thus we are dividing 9 by 1, which is equals to 9. So here 9 is the estimated quotient. So now we have got the estimated quotient as 9. On the basis of this estimated quotient, let's find the actual quotient. For this, we will multiply 13 by estimated quotient, that is 9. we get 117. But 117 is greater than 94. So we cannot take this 9 as our actual quotient. So let's multiply 13 by 8 this time. We get 104, which is still greater than 94. So again, we cannot take 8 as the actual quotient. So let's try once more and multiply 13 by 7 this time. We get 91, which is smaller than 94. So it means 7 is our actual quotient. So 13 into 7 equals to 91, and 94 minus 91 equals to 3. So our quotient equals to 7 and remainder equals to 3. Now let's check our answer by using the same formula which we learned earlier. That is, dividend equals to quotient into divisor plus remainder. So let's put the values here. We get 7 into 13 plus 3. 7 into 13 is 91 and plus 3 equals to 94, which is equal to the given dividend. So it means our answer is correct. Students, we have a separate video on complete chapter of geometry for class 4. In this video, you can learn about points and segments, line, ray, how to measure and draw line segments. Then you can also learn about types of angles, how to measure angles, circles and how to draw circles, and lot more related to geometry. Now, let's understand division of 3-digit number by a 2-digit number. Question is, divide 901 by 19. So, let's form a tent and put dividend 901 inside the tent and divisor 19 outside the tent. Now, since the divisor is of 2-digit number, so let's consider first 2 digits of dividend, that is 90. And since 90 is greater than 19, so we can start with the division. But we first need to estimate the quotient. So let's round off these numbers. 90 rounds off to 90 only, and 19 rounds off to 20. Cancel 0 by 0. So we have to divide 9 by 2. On dividing, we get the quotient as 4, which is our estimated quotient. So to find the actual quotient, let's multiply 19 by this estimated quotient 4. So 19 multiplied by 4 equals to 76, which is smaller than 90. So let's try multiplying 19 by 5. We get 95, which is greater than 90. So it means actual quotient is 4. So 19 into 4 equals to 76. And 90 minus 76 equals to 14. Now copy the last digit 1. So we have to divide 141 by 19. So let's estimate the quotient here. 141 rounds off to 140, and 19 again rounds off to 20. Cancel 0 by 0. So we have to divide 14 by 2, which is equals to 7. So students, 7 is the estimated quotient here. Now with the help of this estimated quotient, we will find actual quotient. 19 multiplied by 7 equals to 133, and 133 is less than 141. So let's multiply 19 by 8 also. We get 152, which is greater than 141. So it means our actual quotient is 7. So 19 multiplied by 7 equals to 133, and 141 minus 133 equals to 8. So students, our answer is quotient equals to 47 and remainder equals to 8. Now let's try and check our answer with the formula which we learnt before, which is dividend equals to quotient into divisor plus remainder. So here quotient is 47 and divisor is 19 and remainder is 8. So 47 multiplied by 19 equals to 893 plus 8 equals to 901, which is same as the given dividend. So it means our answer is correct. Quotient equals to 47 and remainder equals to 8. Students, for more questions on division of 3-digit by 2-digit number, you can refer to a separate video. You will find lot of questions for your practice in this video. The link to this video is below in the description box. Now let's learn division of 4-digit number by 2-digit number. Question is, divide 3708 by 18. So let's form a tank and put 3708 inside the tank and 18 outside the tank. Here divisor is of 2-digit number, so let's consider first 2 digits, that is 37. And since 37 is greater than divisor 18, so it means we can start with the division. So let's first estimate the quotient here. So let's round off both the numbers. 37 rounds off to 40 and 18 rounds off to 20. Cancel 0 by 0. So we have to divide 4 by 2, which is equals to 2. So 2 is the estimated quotient here. Now, to find the actual quotient, we will multiply 18 by estimated quotient 2. We get 36, and 36 is very close to 37. So it means our actual quotient is 2. 18 into 2 equals to 36, and 37 minus 36 equals to 1. Now copy next digit 0. We get 10, but 10 is smaller than divisor 18, so we cannot divide it. So we will do 18 into 0 equals to 0, and 10 minus 0 equals to 10. Now students, we will copy the last digit 8. So now we have to divide 108 by 18. So for this, we will find the estimated quotient again. So let's round off both the numbers. 108 rounds off to 110 and 18 rounds off to 20. Cancel 0 by 0. And now we are left with 11 divided by 2. On dividing, we get 5 as the estimated quotient. So now let's find the actual quotient on the basis of estimated quotient. 18 multiplied by 5 equals to 90. And 90 is less than 108. So let's multiply by 6 this time. 18 multiplied by 6 equals to 108, which is what we want. So it means 6 is the actual quotient here. So 18 multiplied by 6 equals to 108, and 108 minus 108 equals to 0. So our division is complete now. We get the answer as quotient equals to 206 and remainder equals to 0. Students, for more questions related to division of 4-digit by 2-digit number, you can refer to our separate video. This video has many questions which will help you to practice such division thoroughly. You will find the link to this video below in the description box. Now let's learn how to solve word problems related to division. First word problem is 828 oranges are packed in 36 boxes. How many oranges are packed in each box? So students, here we are given with number of oranges which are to be packed in certain number of boxes. And we have to find number of oranges to be packed in each box. So it is a clear case of division. Students, to solve any word problem, first we need to write the statements. So let's write them. Total number of oranges equals to 828. And number of boxes equals to 36. So to find oranges to be packed in each box, we will divide 828 by 36. So let's divide. Let's use the same method to estimate the quotient which we learnt before. So we have to divide 82 by 36, which means we have to divide 80 by 40, which is equals to 2. So let's take quotient as 2. 36 multiplied by 2 equals to 72, and 82 minus 72 equals to 10. Copy the last digit 8. So now we have to divide 108 by 36. Students, 108 is slightly bigger than 72. So let's try 36 multiplied by 3. We get 108 only. So 108 minus 108 equals to 0. So our quotient is 23 and remainder is 0. So our answer is 23 oranges. Don't forget to write the answer statement. 23 oranges are packed in each box. Next word problem is 626 people took a bus to reach Shimla. 15 people can sit in one bus. So how many buses are needed? Students, as I told you, to solve any word problem, first we need to write statements. Number of people equals to 626. People in each bus equals to 15. So to find number of buses needed for 626 people, we will divide 626 by 15. So let's divide. Again, we will use the same method to estimate the quotient. So 62 divided by 15 means 60 divided by 20, which is equals to 3. So let's take quotient as 3. So 15 into 3 equals to 45, which is less than 62. So let's try 15 into 4, which is equals to 60, and it is very close to 62. So let's take 4 as quotient here. So 15 into 4 equals to 60, and 62 minus 60 equals to 2. Now copy the last digit 6. So we have to divide 26 by 15 now. Students, here we can take 1 as the quotient because we know 15 multiplied by 2 equals to 30. So 15 into 1 equals to 15, and 26 minus 15 equals to 11. So we get the quotient as 41 and the remainder equals to 11. So students, it means we need 41 buses plus 1 bus for 11 people left. So it means our answer is 42 buses. Don't forget to write the answer statement. 42 buses are needed for 626 people. Students, for more word problems related to division, you can refer to a separate video. This video will be very useful for you to practice word problems related to division. Now in the end, I am giving you a worksheet for your practice. So students, these are the questions for your practice. Do solve them and you can write your answers in the comments box. Thanks for watching. Do watch my other videos too and share my channel and my videos further. Bye-bye. See you in the next video.